Stakeholders from both the public and private sectors, as well as civil society, convened on Monday to discuss the country's progress in meeting its climate commitments. During the meeting, participants were informed about the advancements made in implementing the nationally determined contributions and upcoming projects that require support from all stakeholders. Currently, St. Lucia is seeking financial resources to achieve these commitments.
Within the NDC, we have three sections: mitigation, which looks at reducing greenhouse gas emissions. We have adaptation, which looks at responding to the experience impacts of climate change, and then we have loss and damage. So right now we're working with sector agencies to take stock of the projects that they have. We're quantifying the emissions that have already been reduced, whether it's from a PV plant that has been developed, whether it's by Lucilec, whether it's by Ministry of Health, wherever, those type of projects, renewable energy projects, energy efficiency projects, and monitoring them to understand how much emissions we have reduced to see if we're getting closer to the target.
The National Climate Change Committee meeting comes ahead of the UN Climate Change Conference, or COP28, which will be held from November 30th until December 12, 2023. The COP28 summit is unique because it will feature the first ever global stocktake of progress since the International Paris Agreement on Climate Change was adopted in 2015, creating a critical moment for more ambitious climate action. A global stocktake synthesis report published in September 2023 outlined a damning report card of current global efforts to confront climate change. A key task for climate negotiations at COP28 is to fully operationalize the Loss and Damage Fund, which was established at the end of long negotiations at COP27. The fund will help climate vulnerable nations like St. Lucia address severe impacts of climate change that cannot be adapted to.
We look at adaptation. We know that there are things that we can do to help us deal with the adverse impacts of climate change. However, there are some impacts of climate change that are permanent, irreparable, irreversible, and we need to find ways to assist countries in addressing and dealing with this. So we want to be able to make progress on running and operating this climate change fund at COP28. And for some, if this does not happen at COP28, for some, they would have felt that COP has failed.
While St. Lucia has not yet met its NDC targets, the country is working to meet its climate commitments with critical reliance on collaboration between the public and private agencies, as well as investments from these sectors. For the DBS News World, I am Zane Rombulus.